know that Africans have a lot of talent, a lot of young players. So being nominated between among those players is an honor for me.
After that plenty of goals, suddenly Chelsea have nosedived. What is responsible for this sliding form?
Thank you, everyone. I mean, you know, it's easy to point some responsible, but I think it's everyone and team, and we have to, you know, we have to work together and try to pass this difficult situation.
And the coach is gone after 7 months. What was your initial reaction when you got it, your first reaction, and what is the future of Chelsea now that Scolari is gone?
I don't know. I mean, I don't know who is coming for in his place. But the most important is to try to win games, because once you back to win games, you know, you forgot about the problems and everything work out the way you want. So yeah.
What is the difference between Scolari and Jose Mourinho?
The difference is Mourinho stayed 4 years and Scolari stayed.
Excuse me, your teammate and brother Drogba has not been playing like we used to. Drogba we used to see in the last maybe 12 months or so.
Yeah, but
what's the problem with Drogba?
Drogba he came from injury, and you know our player is difficult to come back when you have a long out from injury. So I hope that you know, he will be back on his level, and he's working hard and training. He's coming on his top. So I think he just need time, and you gonna see the real Drogba again.
So he's not moving to Inter.
I don't know. That's Drogba decision. I think he's the one who gonna decide if he gonna move or not. I'm his teammate and friend, so I wish all the best.
As an attacker in Chelsea, when you have a Mikel in the middle, how does that make you feel when you are on the field?
It make me feel secure. It make me feel thinking about going forward and not thinking about coming defending, because I know there is someone that behind me who gonna, you know, who gonna do the job and clear the ball and keep the ball and try to make the team play. And that's why he do great, Mika. And he's like I say, this year he's have been playing really well, and he's one of the best players right now for me at Chelsea.
Okay, you talked about the
World Cup. The qualifier will start next month. What are the chances of Cote d'Ivoire playing the World Cup, an African team?
Yeah,
the final to say.
It's great. I mean, we're playing with Guinea, Burkina Faso, and Malawi. And Guinea and Burkina Faso, we always play against them, so we know which kind of team they are. So it's a good advantage for us, and I think we have a good chance to qualify. But you know, that's football, and every time you get on the pitch, you know, you can play against small team. But if you're not ready, they can make a problem for you. So we have to be focused, and our main goal have to be to play in South Africa, because it's in Africa, and I think all the big teams should be there. All African big teams should be there to represent African on the top level.
It's called the all-important goal against Nigeria in the second day.
Yeah.
Then at the semi-final, you just crash like a pack of cards to Egypt. What happened between the Allianz when you are doing so well and the quarterfinal and the semi-final?
Yeah, you know, that's the thing too. When you start the competition so well, and everyone thinking, oh, they're gonna win. Sometimes you lose concentration, and when you get on the important game and you lose that concentration, you pay. And that's what happened to us. When we went to the semi-final, everyone was so confident and knowing that we win every game easy, so they were thinking, oh, it's gonna happen again. But sometimes in football, there is different situation. And you know, against Egypt, it was a different situation, and there was more match prepared than us, and they show it on the pitch.
Yeah.